Every professional technician understands how important it is to service the engine oil and filter. It's how often it should be serviced that often raises controversy. What should you be recommending to your customer? Stick around, that's the topic for this edition of The Trainer. I'm sure you've all seen that popular commercial featuring the miniaturized NASCAR superstar telling the do-it-yourselfer that that new fabulous oil he's promoting will protect his car's engine for 12 months or 20,000 miles. Then there's the mechanic down the street who still tells his customers to change the oil and filter every 3 months or 3,000 miles. Who's right? What should we be recommending to our customers? I guess the first question we should tackle is, why change the oil at all? And don't laugh, there are some OEMs who are working on lifetime engine oil fills. And the truth is, any good quality base oil, whether it's used in a synthetic or mineral oil, will degrade slowly in normal use. The reason we can't leave the oil in there forever is twofold. The first reason has to do with the additive packages that are included in today's oils. You know, you've heard me talk about this before when it's related to coolant or brake fluid. Yes, oil too has an additive package that's designed to help it resist those factors that would cause it to break down into normal use. And as the additive package is depleted, the oil can begin to oxidize and become a more acidic fluid that's going to accelerate the wear on critical component surfaces, like main and rod bearings. Second, we need to periodically dump out the contaminants that have collected in the oil. An older SAE study showed an almost linear relationship between the age of the oil and the rate of wear in the engine. And if the filter is left in service longer than it was designed to be, it will eventually become restricted, reducing vital oil flow to the engine and causing the bypass valve to open. If that happens, what used to be nice, clean, filtered oil will be replaced with oil that is contaminated with all sorts of debris, and that's going to rapidly increase the wear on all the engine's internal parts. So now that we understand why we have to service the oil and filter, let's talk about service intervals. Back in the days of carbureted engines and low-quality mineral oils, the 3-month, 3,000-mile service interval made sense. Today, though, some manufacturers are listing intervals as high as 15,000 miles and more. One reason for this increased interval is the design improvements made to the automobile engine in the last 30 years. Today's engines are more efficient and more tightly sealed, with less combustion blow-by than the big gas guzzlers of the late 70s. Modern computer-controlled engine management means less fuel washing down cylinder walls and less liquid contamination of the lubricating oil. Another and equally important reason is the improvements not only in oil chemistry, but the advances made in oil filtration. Without these two, the extended service intervals of today would not be possible. So make sure that you're using an oil that meets not only the OEM viscosity specification, but the API and/or ILSAC rating as well. And remember, the ratings are a minimum standard. Just like your high school graduating class, there will be those in the group that excelled and those that just squeaked by. The control of solid contaminants is critical to protecting the engine from accelerated wear. And the size of these particles is measured in microns. How big is a micron? 40 microns is about the size of the grain particles in fine flour. It's also about the smallest size the human eye can see. But trapping particles that size and larger is not enough to truly protect the engine. Here's an interesting fact to consider. In an old GM study, engineers discovered that if they could increase filtration, that is, capture particles down to 30 microns in size, they could improve engine wear by a whopping 50%. And if they could improve filtration to capture particles down to 15 microns in size, engine wear improved 70%. Another measurement filters are subjected to in their testing is capacity, or how much dirt and debris can they hold before they can hold no more. The type of filter media used, as well as the total surface area the filter media has, goes a long way in determining that capacity. I think you can see where I'm going with this. Using a quality oil and a cheap filter is not doing your customer any favors. And if you're going to switch them over to an extended interval oil, or switch them from conventional oil to synthetic, all in the name of increasing their service interval, if you don't match that with a filter capable of handling the extra load, it's just a recipe for disaster. So how do you know what filter to select? Well, it's been my personal experience that expensive doesn't always mean good, but cheap is almost always cheap. There isn't a rating requirement, though there are SAE standards for filter performance. When I'm choosing a filter, one of the comparisons I make is weight. It sounds rather unscientific, but a filter with more filter media in it will hold more contaminants than one with less, and way more too. Another consideration is the type of filter media the filter uses. Typical automotive filters use cellulose fiber media that can usually trap about 97% of debris 15 to 40 microns in size, depending on the design. But they may not have the capacity that filters made with a hybrid or synthetic fiber media, or be able to trap the smaller particles that these filters can. And why is that critical? Well, consider that on a modern engine, the piston and the cylinder wall clearance is less than 10 microns. And the abrasive dust suspended in the oil is harder than some of the tools in your toolbox. The piston and bearing surfaces are a lot softer in comparison, so it doesn't take much imagination to understand what's happening to these critical surfaces. Another factor to consider is the overall construction of the filter. Will it hold up under high pressure? Does it have a quality drain back valve to keep the oil filter filled between starts and the dirty oil it holds from draining back into the sump? Is the backing on the media cardboard or something a little more robust? And is it designed to meet the OEM specifications for its own original equipment filters? Well, now that we've got the oil and filter angle covered, let's talk about a few of the factors you need to consider when you're helping your customer choose the most appropriate service interval for them. First, stick to the OEM recommended maintenance schedule. But even then, you may have to customize it a bit for your customer. Some OEMs still list two different maintenance schedules based on use, normal or severe. Discuss this honestly with your customer. If they use the vehicle as a grocery getter and it rarely runs more than 5 miles at a time, you'll need to recommend a higher service interval for them. The same is true for your customers that tow heavy loads a lot, or if you're living in an area where most of the roads are dirt rather than paved. Another and equally important consideration is the normal oil consumption rate for the engine in the vehicle that your customer owns. Now consider some OEMs have rates as little as 1 quart every 2,000 miles, so if you've set them up on an extended service interval of, say, 15,000, well, I think you can see where I'm going with that. I mean, after all, when was the last time you knew of a customer that checked their own oil? Additionally, many vehicles have some form of oil life monitoring system. Now, the early ones were pure mileage counters, no big deal, but many of the new ones use an algorithm that tracks certain driving parameters and it adjusts the service interval accordingly. Even so, advise your customers that no matter what that oil life monitoring system says, that oil should still be changed at a minimum of once a year. And if you do happen to change it before the oil life monitoring system says so, make sure that you reset the system so it starts tracking anew. Helping our customers maintain their vehicles is at the heart of what we do. Helping them customize an oil change interval that meets their needs and driving habits, and then performing that service with quality products will help us go a long way in accomplishing just that. Thanks for watching.